What's up, everybody? Welcome back. So we are continuing with some more season 4 battles in the Go Battle League. And the talk of the town basically has been about Galvantula. And Galvantula has obviously become so much more viable in the Great League, especially after the introduction of the move Lunge, which is pretty broken in my opinion, because it has a 100% chance of lowering your opponent's attack and also does a pretty decent amount of damage as well, right? But Galvantula is not the only Pokemon which can learn Lunge. There's another Pokemon which is Masquerain, which can also learn Lunge. And of course, Masquerain is not going to be as good as Galvantula, but I felt like it was going to be pretty interesting, which is why I decided to try it out in this particular team comp alongside Registeel and Shadow Swampert as well. And overall, it was actually pretty decent. Not the most perfect or ideal team comp, but overall, it actually worked pretty well. So let's just get straight into it. Okay, moving on to the first battle here. And I'm going to be running Masquerain with Air Slash, Lunge and Ominous Wind. The reason I'm running Ominous Wind over Bubble Beam is because we already have a debuff move in Lunge, whereas Ominous Wind could provide better coverage in a lot of neutral matchups. But anyways, we have Masquerain into Toxicroak. Very favorable matchup because Air Slash is doing super effective damage. And Charge Bomb coming through. This is too soon to be a Sludge Bomb, so I'm going to let this go through. And it's just a Mud Bomb, which is triple resisted because of the bug and flying typing. They make a switch into their Galarian Stunfisk, and I go straight into Swampert. Now, we were slightly slow to switch out because there was a little bit of lag there. And I'm going to shield this up because if it's Earthquake, it would do a lot of damage. But unfortunately, they bait with Rock Slide. So I'm going to build up to two Hydro Cannons and then go back to back here. This is obviously going to do super effective damage because of the ground typing on the Stunfisk. So yeah, I'm just trying to get to another one, but I'm like, okay, this has to be an Earthquake, right? Which is why I shield this up. But unfortunately, they bait again with Rock Slide. So that was very nice play on their part. So I'm going to build up a little extra energy and then go again for Hydro Cannon. Let's see if this gets their final shield here. I really want to maintain switch advantage because I want to make sure that my Registeel is not lined up against their Toxicroak. So luckily, it's just another Rock Slide, which is really good. They make a switch into their Ferrothorn and I go straight into Registeel here. Now, this is a very favorable matchup because Registeel basically resists all of Ferrothorn's moves except for Thunder. So Charge move coming through. This is just a Power Whip, which is resisted. And I'm going straight for the Focus Blast here. This is obviously going to do super effective damage because of the Steel typing and should almost one-shot it. And this is perfect, right? Now this Ferrothorn is in perfect lock-on farm down range, which is really crucial. Charge move coming through. Nothing they have is really going to take us out from this range. It's the Thunder, which is absolutely fine. And we should be able to completely farm this thing down here, which is really crucial because they're going to come back in with Toxicroak, but we have a Flash Cannon ready to go. And this is easily going to take it out from this range because Toxicroak is extremely glassy. And I'm going to immediately switch into my Masquerain and go for the Lunge here. Now, even though Lunge is resisted, it's going to lower the Stunfisk's attack. And it's basically their last Pokemon. They can't switch out to clear the debuffs, which is really crucial. Charge move coming through. It's going to be a Rock Slide, which is easily going to one-shot it because Masquerain is double weak to Bug because of the flying and double weak to Rock because of the flying and Bug typing. And I'm going to come in with Registeel because I know they have extra energy and I want to basically soak up that energy before bringing in my Swampert. But I'm going straight for the Flash Cannon here. This is almost going to take out the Stunfisk. Almost takes it out there. And they are overfarming quite a bit. So if it's Rock Slide, it probably would not KO. But they actually go straight for the Earthquake. And yeah, we're able to come back with Swampert and then Mudshot down there. So that was actually pretty close. I'm pretty sure that Stunfisk had a little extra energy. Maybe if they'd gone for Rock Slide and then farmed down, they probably could have won. But I guess Swampert might have survived a Rock Slide from that range. But anyways, it was pretty close nevertheless. So we have Masquerain into a Froslass. Now, this is not a good matchup because we're taking super effective damage from the Powder Snow. So I'm immediately going to save switch into my Registeel here. And they are still staying in this matchup. And they're probably going to go for the Shadow Ball because that would hit for neutral, whereas Avalanche would be resisted. It is the Shadow Ball that does a decent amount of damage there. And they make a switch into their Gengar and I go straight for the Flash Cannon here. Now, because we have loaded energy, this is actually a pretty positive situation to be in. Now, obviously, Gengar is extremely glassy. They are obviously going to shield that up. I'm really trying to get to another Flash Cannon here, but Charge Move coming through. I'm just going to risk it and hope that this is just a Shadow Punch because we can survive that. It is just a Shadow Punch, which is perfect. I'm going straight for the next Flash Cannon here. And let's see if this gets their final shield. They actually let that go through and it pretty much one-shots it there, which is really great. And let's see what they have in the back. I'm actually surprised they let that go through. They have Shiftry in the back. So now they're going to try and completely farm us down. But Registeel is just so tanky, right? Registeel is still so OP and I'm able to get to another Flash Cannon here. They actually let that go through, which is really good because now a couple of Air Slashes should take it out, right? So I'm going to come in with my Masquerain and I'm going to risk it by not shielding the first one because even if it's Foul Play, it's not going to KO. But luckily, they go for the Leaf Blade. Now, that is obviously double resisted because of the bug and flying typing. And Frostlass is going to come in, and we're going straight for the Ominous Wind, right? This is one of the specific matchups where Ominous Wind helps. They're probably going to think this is a buck type move, and they're probably not going to shield this, and boom, as you can see, does super effective damage because of the ghost typing. Unfortunately, they're able to farm us down, but it's fine, right? We still have two shields, and they barely have any health, and one mud shot should pretty much take it out from this range. So, yeah, one mud shot takes it out, and they basically lost with a shield, but they probably expected that to be a bug move, which is why they probably saved the shields till the end, but I guess Ominous Wind maybe caught them off guard there. So anyways, moving into the next battle, we are 2-0 in this set right now, but we do face some challenges here. So obviously, Masquerain is not the most perfect Pokemon to use. So we have Masquerain into a regular Stunfisk. Now this is obviously not a great matchup because we're taking super effective damage from the electric moves because of the flying typing. And I'm going to shield the first one because I really want to land this lunge and lower the Stunfisk's attack before switching into my Registeel. Obviously, I'm going to safe switch into Registeel and not switch into my hard counter Swampert. So I'm going to come in with Registeel now. Now, because their attack is lowered, Mud Bomb is not going to do as much as it originally would have, which is really nice, right? They're probably going to need an additional Mud Bomb to basically get rid of my Registeel. So yeah, another Charge Boom coming through. As you can see, Mud Bomb is really not doing that much in spite of being super effective. Yeah, it's going to take basically two more of those to get rid of Registeel. So I'm going straight for the Focus Blast here. This is definitely going to finish off the Stunfisk from this range if it goes unshielded. Actually, it gets the shield, which is absolutely fine. And I'm really trying to get to another Focus Blast here, but we're not able to. So another Charge Bomb coming through. This Mud Bomb is not going to take us out, right? It's going to put us pretty low. I'm trying to get to a Focus Blast, but they're able to get to another Charge move, which is absolutely fine because I'm going to let this go through, and because I can now come in with Swampert and completely farm down, right? So I'm not going to throw the Charge move. I'm just going to completely farm the Stunfisk down here. I'm not going to shield this because Mud Bomb is obviously, they are debuffed at this point, so it's not going to do as much as it originally would have. And they're probably going to get to another Mud Bomb here, and this is going to put Swampert into the yellow, but we're going to come out of this matchup with a lot of loaded energy, right? And Swampert with loaded energy can be extremely dangerous here, so just going to completely Mud Shot farm this thing down. Let's see what they have in the back. They come in with their Abomasnow, so I'm going to bait with Hydro Cannon. I'm really hoping they fall for this bait, because if they do, I can go straight for the Sludge Wave. Unfortunately, they don't shield that, so I immediately go into my Masquerain here, and I'm going to shield this up because my Swampert has very minimal health, that it's probably going to be taken down by, you know, Powder Snow. So they actually have a Quagsire in the back, so I'm going immediately for the lunge here. Now this is going to do neutral damage or get their final shield, and yeah, at this point they're probably going to throw the Charge move here. This is either going to be a Stone Edge or a Sludge Bomb. It is a Sludge Bomb, which is going to take out the Masquerain, and I'm going to build up two Hydro Cannons and then go back to back here. I'm really hoping this Hydro Cannon takes out this Quagsire because I need another Hydro Cannon ready to go to get rid of the Abomasnow, but unfortunately it doesn't take it out, and I know I can't Mud Shot it down because Quagsire is, I mean, it's not glassy because it's fairly tanky, right? So yeah, because we didn't have loaded energy, Abomasnow is going to be able to come back and, you know, sort of farm us down there. So I mean it was crucial that we basically had to get rid of the Quagsire with Hydro Cannon. Unfortunately, they survived with a little bit of health, and it was very difficult to Mud Shot it down from that range as well, right? So anyways, moving into the fourth battle, we have Masquerain into Azumarill. So this is a very interesting matchup, but we do have to watch out for Ice Beam, of course, which would hit for super effective. Now I'm going straight for the Ominous Wind here because Lunge is resisted because of the Fairy typing. Probably could have gone for the Lunge because I would have got the attack debuff. Now I was trying to switch into my Registeel to catch the Ice Beam, but unfortunately I think it was a CMP. So I'm going to actually let this go through because I'll take the shield advantage at this point. So I'm going to come in with Registeel here and then go straight for the Flash Cannon. So this is one of the reasons why I run Registeel instead of Galarian Stunfisk in my team comp, is basically to provide, I mean, to be able to handle Azu and Grass types, right? Because Stunfisk basically loses against Azu and also against most of the Grass types, whereas Registeel can obviously handle Grass types and can handle Azu as well. So anyways, I'm going straight for the next Flash Cannon here. This is probably going to take out the Azu from this range if it goes unshielded, as it does there. And they have a Whiscash in the back. Now this is where I make a key mistake. I probably should have let them hit me with a Mud Bomb and then switch it into my Shadow Swampert, because now that Whiscash has loaded energy as well. So I'm going to build up to two Hydro Cannons and then go back to back here. Now the first one doing over 50% of Skarmory's health. Now the second one should definitely get the shield from the Skarmory because they have so much loaded energy. They do shield that up, which is fine. And Charge Move coming through. This, I'm obviously going to shield this up because I basically need to rely on my Swampert to get rid of their Whiscash as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to overfarm just a little bit past the Hydro Cannon and throw the Hydro Cannon just before they can get to a Sky Attack, right? Now this is definitely going to finish off the Skarmory from this range. And now, charge move coming through from the Whiscash, and I'm going to shield this up. Now, I'm not going to be able to get to the Hydro Cannon before they can get to a Mud Bomb, right? Because they have so much loaded energy. So I'm going to sack my Registeel here to try and catch the Mud Bomb. But the problem is that Mud Bomb is not going to KO, right? So this is one of those situations where Registeel's tankiness can sometimes work against you, because now they can completely farm us down. And we don't have a Hydro Cannon on Swampert yet, which is really unfortunate. So I'm going for the Flash Cannon to basically put it into Hydro Cannon range. We're one Mud Shot away from Hydro Cannon, but we're not at a Hydro Cannon yet. But they're able to get to a Mud Bomb here. Now, this is definitely going to finish off the Shadow Swampert. Now, if it was a regular Swampert, then it probably could have survived. But obviously, Shadow Swampert is glassy and, you know, it's going to take it out there. So we are 2-2 in the set right now. Let's see if we can finish on a positive note. As you can see, there are some downsides of running Masquerain on the lead. But anyways, we have Masquerain to Whiscash. Now, this is a very favorable matchup because Mud Shots and Mud Bomb are triple resisted because of the bug and flying typing. This was too soon to be a Blizzard, so it's just going to be a Mud Bomb. Does almost nothing to a Masquerain there. And I'm just going to go straight for the lunge here. Now, this is going to do neutral damage and also lower the Whiscash's attack. And should put it pretty low, actually. Does put it pretty low there. And another charge bomb coming through. This is definitely going to be a Mud Bomb, right? It was way too soon to be a Blizzard. It's just a Mud Bomb, does almost nothing again because they're debuffed as well. They make a switch into their Galvantula and it goes into Swampert. Now, this is not the most ideal situation because now we are slightly behind on energy because they get off their lungs there. So we are debuffed at this point. I'm going straight for the Hydro Cannon here. This is probably going to get the shield from the Galvantula. And I'm really trying to get to another Hydro Cannon. But yeah, they're able to get to the lunge first. So obviously going to shield this up again because it would do a lot of damage to Swampert. So I'm going straight for the Hydro Cannon. We are double debuffed at this point, and they're probably going to shield this up as well because it's still going to do a lot of damage. They shield that up, and now it's just a race to the charge bomb. I'm really hoping I can get to a Hydro Cannon here. Luckily, we're able to get to a Hydro Cannon before they can get to another lunge, and this is probably still going to take out the Galvantula because it's just so glassy. They come in with Whiscash, and I make it switch into my Masquerain, and they come in with Skarmory. So this is not a great matchup, obviously. So I'm going straight for the Ominous Wind here because it would hit for neutral. Probably should have gone for the lunge because could have lowered its attack. But anyways, doesn't matter at this point because I can come in with Registeel and completely wall this Skarmory here. And my aim in this matchup is obviously they're going to try and wait out the switch clock to hopefully switch out. But I have to land a Focus Blast on the Skarmory. I know their switch timer is coming back up soon. But I'm really hoping that I can land a Focus Blast before they can switch out. So luckily we're able to get to a Focus Blast here. Now this is going to do some heavy neutral damage to Skarmory because of the steel and flying typing. And should put it pretty low there. Puts it extremely low. They make a switch into their Whiscash. And they're going to throw a charge move here. This is going to be a Mud Bomb, which is not going to KO. So as soon as they throw the charge move, I'm going to immediately switch into my Swampert and try and get to the Hydro Cannon here. And obviously Swampert wins CMP against Whiscash. So this Hydro Cannon is definitely going to finish off the Whiscash from this range. And Skarmory is coming in and it's going to go down to Mud Shot there. So pretty close. I mean, overall, I would say it was pretty decent. It was an experiment that was worth trying. As you can see, we went 3-2. I guess with any team comp you try, any new Pokemon you try, I guess going positive is the ultimate thing, right? I mean, going 3-2, I guess that's a win for me. But obviously, I would have preferred a 4-1 or a 5-0, but it's all good. But yeah, again, these were some competitive rank 6 battles. You don't see any of those lower rank spies as much anymore. I mean, obviously, as the seasons progress, you know, it's getting more and more competitive, which is always a lot of fun. But anyways, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.